Esco came about just going to Magic City. They were going to Magic City, man, just used to go over his house, having our own relationship, just building off music and just talking about the music, about mixtapes, and then, man, people didn't even know it was cool.
2009, we finally got together, and we just decided we were gonna do this together, and he wanted to get out the streets. And the best thing to do was just hang out with me, because I didn't hang out with no one, so we just hanging out together and made the dream come true.
And then when they be playing my songs of Magic, shit, nobody don't even know we building the story. So people calling me like, man, that dude, the Esco and goddamn Magic, man, he playing your shit all the time. You need to thank him, man. I'm on the phone talking to him like, man, for real? What he played last night? But nigga played that, watch this, but that, yeah, with 2 Chainz, but all that shit, but he played that shit. Like, oh, for real, man, all right, man. Yeah, I'm going there to tell the nigga tonight. I'm with Esco, we laughing about this shit. Next thing you know, it just started working. Like, man, we ain't never gonna tell nobody. You know what I'm saying?
Then we gotta keep it like this until we can't hold it anymore. You know what I'm saying? So we did that, and then we got the buzz going. He got hot, started getting hot in the city, and then we did a mixtape together, and Dirty Sprite. And
Esco never wanted nothing from me from the beginning. He always just wanted to see me do good. And it showed, you know what I'm saying? The way he moved, his motives, when he never feel like he had no ulterior motives. He checked out, he stayed solid, stayed loyal. Esco done seen me go through relationships, have kids, make music, come up from the bottom, start from nothing, have success, have songs on the radio, go through everything with music, without music. He know my ear, he know when I'm on, he know when I need to really focus and get back in there. He know when I'm not focused. He know when something getting to me. Cause he done seen different parts of my life. He done seen me elevate. He done seen me grow in so many ways. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So it's only right that I can trust his ear and I can trust his judgment on certain things. Everything I did 6 years ago, it was far away from this shit. I was trying to get some money the wrong way. That's why I don't never regret it. Like, working so hard. Because I hate the life I used to live.
Fuck what you heard, God blessing all the trout niggas. God blessing all the trout niggas.
You know, they be like, man, crazy in Chicago, but I understand it. It is what it is, but man, when I come here, man, they roll the red carpet out so much love. Like, the homies hold me all the way down from every which way, every corner, every trap, every cut. It's a lot of love.
You think it's because your music speaks to them, always have?
Yeah, yeah. That played a major role, just my character, like, and my respect, and just the way I carry myself played a major role, too. Yeah. Pre-band game. Why? Future Hendrix. Pop sitting in the hood with some gangsters. Don't be coming around here false claiming. Don't you come around here false claiming. Better not come around here false claiming. Yeah. Let me hear that part. Yeah. When I go back and I record in the middle of the living room, because sometimes people are always always making excuses if they can't record somewhere. But shit, you see me, I record a smash and they ain't have no problem with doing it. As long as I got a mic, as long as somebody got a laptop and they can record me, that's all I need. It's no excuses when you want to get somewhere in life. My dog, he really was on house arrest, so that's how I really was over there for him. He was on house arrest and he couldn't get out the house, and we always be together. And I was like, damn, when I get to the city, I'm gonna make sure I come over there and check you. So we went over there and I was just hanging with him at his house because shit, that's where his leg monitor was at. I mean, I feel I had to make a choice, you know what I'm saying? If I wanted this full time, I wanted this 100%, then I gotta put 100% effort into it and put all my time into it and just put my heart and my soul into something that I want so bad. So that's what I did. I'm in another environment. I get a chance to live lavishly majority of the time of the day, you know what I mean? I'm in a 5-star hotel or I'm at a 5-star restaurant, but I come from nothing. I come from the street, so sometimes out of my day, I go back and I reminisce and I get back into the streets of what made me, and I want to see the people that's a part of that was a part of my life before my success, get a chance to see me successful also, so it can motivate them to become successful one day.
My Uncle Randy used to wash cars. My Uncle Wayne was a kingpin, you know what I'm saying? My Uncle Donald, niggas robbed banks and shit. Rest in peace. My granddaddy was a boss, was a kingpin, you hear me? Got the game from them old niggas. You gotta know where I'm from to get to know a nigga. I still glad to smoke weed. Hiding from the police. I spend time overseas, hanging out in England. And I got the squad on my mind and the meanness. Do a little time out the country, I need this. 56 nights, gotta know the real meaning. Dropped Monster Tape and had to go to Europe. Best thing I ever did was fall out of love. Skull came to me, said they think you washed up. You need to go back in, show these niggas who the one. We going back in soon as we get off tour. He had my hard drive on him when he caught the case. When they took him in custody, they took my life from him.